Hey, what is up everybody? Welcome back to another exciting adventure on our channel. Today we are in Southeast Arizona, back at one of our favorite places here, Apple Annie's Produce and Pumpkin Farm, here to pick some fresh vegetables. Also gonna see if we can sneak over to Chiricahua later, kind of just see where the wind takes us today, but it should be a fun day, so please join us. Well, we got some special guests here today. It's my mom. Want to say hello?
Hello.
And then my dad's here too. He's ready to... So if you guys remember, we've been here back in last October when they have the pumpkin patch open and the corn maze, and we'll be coming back this year to do that, hopefully. So we decided to come here in a different season and try something different and pick some vegetables. So here you can see like the fields where you can pick stuff. You're only supposed to pick from labeled rows, I believe. Not supposed to pick leaves, just the vegetables themselves. So it seems like they have a variety of things. We went back in to check out the map. A lot of peppers, beans, or green beans. I think I saw squash. Well, maybe not squash, maybe zucchini or cucumbers, I think.
Pushing the wheelbarrow.
Here's some okra here. It looks like, oh yeah, that's okra. All right, just kind of wandering out in the fields here now. They actually have artichokes here. They're not ready to pick yet, but you can see. And look at these flowers on the artichokes.
Yeah, I have no idea they did that.
For me, part of the interesting thing about this is you don't really know what the plants look like. You go to the grocery store and, you know, we all eat pre-picked vegetables, but to actually see the plants they grow on is just kind of interesting, I think. Got some hot green chilies here. Look at how huge these green peppers are. I know my mom, who's here, is they're all picking from the end. They gotta get in here. Yeah, I see a lot of peppers over here. Some red ones, too. Here's some nice looking peppers, maybe. Got some nice color, red. Amy's here too, and my parents, they're kind of way off there. A little bit camera shy, I think. So I kind of came off, wandered off this way to go. Still checking out the peppers. They're busy picking, but I need to go hook up with them here to let them know that, man, if you want to find the good stuff, you got to walk out here. Everybody seems to be hanging out towards the end of the rows that seem pretty picked over, so don't be afraid to get on out here. You can see I'm kind of standing in the center of one of the U-pick areas. There's okra over there that we had already seen, but pretty sizable, I would say. Another thing that I love about down here in Southeast Arizona, it's absolutely beautiful country. Just look at the mountains in the background with the farm kind of out in front of it. Just a beautiful sight. Just walking around here is just worth it for me. I think I see a tiny little lizard that lives out here in the field. You guys see the little lizard? Don't be afraid, little lizard. One thing I can tell you for sure is don't forget that sunscreen. It is hot. Sun is rough, and I didn't put any on, I'm dumb. Quick check-in here to see what my mom here has picked. Got some green tomatoes in there.
Yep.
And then what else you got?
Bell peppers, and medium hot peppers, and hot peppers.
Whoa, a lot of bell peppers in there, look at that. You can actually still see some rotted pumpkins and the vines left over from last year's pumpkin patch. This is actually where Amy and I picked our pumpkins from, one of these rows actually, and it's a dust devil. Look at that dust devil. Wow, it keeps breaking up and reforming, but that's pretty cool. Kind of peek in here, you'll see some squash. Big one too, look at that. It's a big, ow, that thing's sharp. That's a yellow squash. All right, we found one of the things we're looking for is zucchini. Amy wants to make a zucchini lasagna, which is actually surprisingly good. Holy crap, look what Amy found. This is the Mac Daddy of zucchinis right here.
Here's some more.
Holy crud, that's a mutant zucchini. Ow, these leaves are sharp. You see that? That's like, I don't know if that comes out on camera for scale. There's my foot. Look at that. Oh my gosh, I've never seen any that big before. Have you, Amy? They got thorns on them now. All right, we're trying to pick one of these. this one seems like a candidate. You know, like, we're trying to debate, like, if we were in a store buying these things, you'd buy like three or four probably smaller ones, right? Like, this thing is probably the equivalent of like five of those. So why not, though? We're just gonna go for it. Look at this thing. I mean, dang, that satisfies our zucchini needs right there in one fell swoop, I think. We also got these, like, look at these, Amy. These are very nice looking. I don't know what we'd use it for. Probably find a recipe, but, you know, are they ready to pick? That's what I don't know. They certainly look ready. We think this is a cucumber over here. Once again, these are mutants. They're huge. Look at that. What the heck would you do with these? You'd be feeding like a huge family. That's where Amy and I are struggling a bit here because we cook a lot, or I should say Amy cooks a lot. I'm not, definitely not the one you want cooking for you, but some of these things are so huge. It's like, you know, it's just the two of us. We don't have kids and or anything. So when we cook, it's kind of challenging to cook for two and not be wasteful. So we're trying to find like reasonable size things. Everything here is just gigantic. I'm picking some cucumbers here. They actually got sharp spines on them. A lot of these plants do. One thing that I like to think about when I'm here at places like this is, what is it like to be a full-time farmer? In my mind, and maybe I'm just painting an unrealistic, idyllic image, I work in an office in corporate America. I always have. I find it very stressful, sometimes frustrating for sure, and sometimes I wonder, the farm life, is that for me? Did I miss my calling? I don't know. I'm not saying that farming is easy by any means, and I'm sure it's stressful. Now you're contending with nature. Do we have enough rain? Are funguses, insects, are they gonna decimate crops, frosts, all of that stuff? So, but I'm curious to get your guys' opinion. If you're a farmer or have experience with it, let me know, like, how do you like your life? And if you're not, like, what do you guys think? Do you think it would be a simpler, more satisfying life, or would you rather work in a cubicle 40, 50 hours a week taking orders from people? I don't know. I think about these things a lot. Yeah, we're just kind of roaming around at this point. I think we've seen most of the stuff, and the rows are really long, so there's plenty to pick, especially if you're into peppers, cucumbers, zucchini, and some squash. No shortage of that at all. So overall, I think we're finishing up here. My parents are back in the little market there with Amy buying their pickings from the day. I think everybody had a great time. I had a great time here. No, the episode's not over yet, by the way. Don't go anywhere. Just kind of tidying up here, finishing up. I prefer the autumn season, and I think Amy does too, the pumpkin patch, which is here at this same location in Corn Maze. We're gonna be back here in 2020 for that, unless the world dissolves away before then. But yeah, this is still a lot of fun. All right, so earlier I was surmising what would be better in life, to work on a farm your whole life or to work in an office. So we have somebody sitting here that has worked both on a farm and in an office. So give us your opinion. If you could do it all over again before retirement, would you rather work in an office your whole life or a farm?
In an office for sure.
Why is that?
Air conditioning.
Air conditioning, there you go.
No bugs.
No bugs. So there you have it. We've made it to Chiricahua. We're gonna start it off by looking at some graves. Anyway, this is right by the entrance, like right over here at Chiricahua, and it's actually free to get in still. They don't charge a fee, you just kind of drive through, but it's always kind of nice to say hello to these folks every time we come here. And I think this is a lot of the Erickson family plot. I think here's a picture of some of the family from the 1800s. Thank you. now we've went from the farm up to 6,800 feet, I believe, to the top of Chiricahua. I believe it's Massai or Massai Point. I'm not hiking today because I'm with my family. We're having a picnic lunch up here, but take you down here a ways really quick. So for those of you that have followed our channel for a while, you may have seen a couple of videos I've done here at Chiricahua. I hiked what's known as the Big Loop, which is a sequence of trails all throughout this wilderness. I circumnavigated virtually everything you see here, and it's amazing, and I actually made two videos from that. We'll put links in the description down below if you want to check those out. I'd highly recommend it. All right, but it's time to eat. I am starving. I have not eaten anything other than a banana. Probably about like 5:30 this morning. Look at this spread. You got what? Cheese sticks, some sandwiches, grapes. This is enough to, you could probably stay overnight here for a few days. Salad, watermelon. My dad said these were the best pretzels in the world. I might have to agree. These are good.
Ducks.
I don't know. This might be overdoing it, but I'm not complaining. Look at that. It's just four of us here. This is a picnic lunch. Amy and I made a couple sandwiches up in here, ham sandwiches. We got some fresh salad up in here. Greek salad. Put some dressing on there. This is like a cooking show up here. Here's what we're dealing with here. This gigantic ham sandwich that Amy prepared. And then this
lettuce?
Greek salad.
On your sandwich?
No.
And this Boylan's black cherry. Interestingly, even though I've hiked through most of this, this is my first time visiting here at Massai Point. You would think I would have been here, which is probably the pinnacle, the grand finale of everything cool in this park. So it's kind of cool to share this with you on the video. All right, so a quick interview here. This is your guys' first time seeing Chiricahua. You've never been here before. So what is your first impression?
Pretty impressive.
Yeah?
I like it. Very different.
All right, I'm gonna head back down because folks are kind of taking turns, being respectful of distance, which is appreciated. So you guys are getting the quick day trip experience of Chiricahua. All right, our next and final stop on our Southeast Arizona road trip, a graveyard. What a better way to end a road trip than by seeing the dead. We're at the old Wilcox Cemetery, where I hear one of the Earp brothers was laid to rest. Yeah, I love cemeteries, and I've never been to this one. Love old pioneer cemeteries. You can see my parents already exploring the cemetery here. It's actually pretty expansive. I thought it would be a lot smaller than this. See a couple headstones there. This is pretty cool, actually. I love the terrain. I love the plants out here and the mountains in the background. Quite a beautiful scene. Check these out. I do not know if this is original. If it is, that would be pretty cool. It very well might be. This is a wooden headstone here. J.E. Williamson died November of 1893. If that's original, you don't really see that too often. And just seeing these random headstones, I mean, these are old, these are original. Died in 1895, so, and I don't know who these people are, but these are beautiful. And this one's just broken to pieces. It's seen its days, covered in fire ants. But, yeah, this is neat. And some more wooden ones here. You know, I mean, I wouldn't be surprised if these actually are relics, like original headstones, maybe from the 1800s in wood. So does anybody out there know if these are original? I'm gonna have to research that. Because if that really is an original piece of wood from 1893 that survived this long, I'd be very impressed, actually. You know, I just wonder though, because like in Boot Hill, All those are all wooden, but they're not originals. They had to replace them because they were so deteriorated with time. So what's there today, I don't think is original anymore. This makes me really question, are those wooden ones the original ones? It seems like they might be, and it's just so neat to see that, because that's probably more common of what it was like back in that era. Like this guy, like right, this one right here. And you can barely make them out. I mean, the only curious thing to me is that they're in concrete and screwed in, and I don't know if that's necessarily how it would have been done back in the day. I'm just guessing the wooden headstone would have been in the ground. One thing you want to be really careful about, it's very sandy back here, and there are a lot of fire ants everywhere. And you really got to be careful where you stand, because you don't want to stand on one of their mounds, believe me. Check it out. It's Warren Baxter Earp. This is Wyatt Earp's younger brother, I believe. That is so cool. Another Wild West legend marked off the list here. Another really cool one you might want to check out, that it's way back there. We're going the wrong direction, but past the Chiricahuas, or past Chiricahua National Monument rather, is the grave of Johnny Ringo. We actually visited that. We give you tips on how to get there. We'll put a link in the description down below to that video too. This would pair really well with that. You could definitely see both of these guys in the same day. And I wouldn't be surprised if they cross paths in reality at some point or another. Very possible. Yeah, as much as I hate to leave this place, I'll have to save this for maybe its own video sometime, do some more research. But overall, yeah, I think we're getting ready to head back to Phoenix. Everybody's had a pretty long and fun day. In case you want to follow our itinerary, we left Phoenix about 6:15 in the morning today, got down to Apple Annie's, the farm, around 9:30 in the morning, spent a good hour and a half there probably, drove to Chiricahua, had a picnic lunch at the very top, saw some beautiful views, did a little teeny bit of hiking to get some better looks at the area, then ended it here, paying our respects to Mr. Earp. Beautiful itinerary, something I would recommend if you want to see multiple things in a day. On a day trip from Phoenix, I would highly recommend it. If you enjoyed this video, please like, share, and subscribe, and look us up on social media at Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. All right, they keep looking at me. Gotta go.